Hi everyone, I'm Johan. Today I'm going to talk to you about the Shopify Data Scientist interview process. At the end of this video, you should have a good understanding of the process itself, what the interviewers filter for, and several tips on preparing yourself for this. Before concluding, I'll talk about one Shopify-specific interview round and how to get through it. Quick intro, I'm from Prepfully. This overview has been put together by Shopify data scientists who are actually also interview coaches on Prepfully, the very same ones who have helped hundreds of candidates with mock interviews and advice. This is a video version of our much more in-depth written guide. We'll link within the description. And you can also book time with the coaches directly for a more personalized guidance on Prepfully's website. Right, on to the overview. As a part of the Shopify data scientist interview, you'll have three rounds. The first, a recruiter phone interview. The second can either be a coding round or a pair programming problem. The final round will usually be a combination of technical and behavioral interviews. Let's start with the recruiter round first. This will be a call with non-technical questions. The objective is to check if your skills match the job role requirement. So you'll get questions about your experience and skills. We have three tips for this round. Be super familiar with your past work. Make sure you have a project you can talk about from each of your previous roles. Organize your thoughts in advance around topics like what your contribution was, how things went, and what you could have done better. Have a clear reason for why you're applying at Shopify, as well as why you think you'd succeed there. Keep answers short and crisp. This round often starts with the old favorite, tell me about yourself. So it's useful to have a nice short intro ready to roll with. Next up is round two, which it can either be a pair programming round or a coding round. In the pair programming round, you'll be paired with a data scientist and given a data set to solve a specific problem. It's often a classification or regression problem, but can also go beyond. A recent candidate reported being asked to work on MapReduce, for instance. If you get a coding problem, it will likely be focused on object-oriented programming in Python. You will be asked to fix bugs and add functionality to the code. There can be some questions related to data science concepts, as well as a few themed around Python and SQL. We've got four tips for this round. Brush up on your object-oriented programming skills. Shopify DSs are expected to be pretty full-stack in nature, and your interviewers will test for this. Practice programming Conway's Game of Life before the interview. This has been reported as a common problem by candidates. Brush up your basics in Python, from recursive functions to operations on lists. Make sure you practice advanced SQL techniques. You should know nested, joins, inner, outer joins, PL, SQL, etc. This step usually has the highest drop-off rate, since candidates often get caught off guard by the breadth of questions which can come up. We'd strongly recommend practicing with someone who can assess you on how you actually perform in an interview. So, get a friend to help you with a mock, or just use a coaching service like Prepfully, where a data scientist can simulate that real-world interview vibe for you and provide specific feedback on how you did. Right, the third step is the final interview rounds. This is a combination of technical and behavioral interviews. You'll have a panel, often senior data scientists, who will assess you across a range of skills and experiences. You will be tested across problem-solving skills, often focusing on data analysts and visualizations. You'll also be tested on product analytics and metrics. And finally, you'll receive several behavioral questions to test your fit. Here are some tips for this round. First, think about how you'd apply statistical techniques to e-commerce businesses and their use cases. This is particularly relevant to Shopify. It's also worth reading up about business fundamentals of e-commerce businesses. Second, work on implementing ETL pipelines and have some understanding of dimensional modeling. Third, brush up on DS fundamentals, probability, statistics, common ML algorithms. Fourth, in behavioral questions, your interviewer wants to understand your cultural fit for Shopify. One example of a question you may be asked is, what's your background and why do you want to work at Shopify? Take some time before the interview to reflect on your background and how it's prepared you for a role at Shopify. Also, give some thought to what specifically attracts you to Shopify and the work they do. Last but not least, the promised bit of advice on Shopify's unique interview round. Shopify has this thing called the life story round, where they want to get to know about your career journey and your achievements, your strengths and your weaknesses, your motivations and decisions, and how you got to this point. It's really important that you frame your experiences in a way that is relevant to Shopify and leads to a logical conclusion for why Shopify would be a good next step for you. Some candidates have reported that they have had this part of the conversation directly at the recruiter stage and didn't face this again during the on-site. In this context, we'd recommend being prepared for questions such as, what's your background and how do you think you reached this stage? Upfront, even for the recruiter rounds. Good, that's all from us. Once you feel ready for some practice or just want a sense check of your preparation level, especially on the custom rounds such as the life journey one, you can book an anonymous mock interview with a data scientist from Shopify on Prepfully. We've included a link in the description below. In addition, I've linked to a bunch of useful resources too, most of which are free. There's a written guide, we have an interview question bank, etc. If you have a follow-up question about the interview, ask it in the comments below. And if you found this video useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.